The prognosis after treatment of Lyme disease is generally very good. The vast majority of people receive their antibiotics, finish them, and return to their normal health. The prognosis is best when Lyme disease is diagnosed and treated early. The prognosis may be less good when the diagnosis and treatment is delayed. The prognosis after the second stage of Lyme disease, that early disseminated stage of infection, is also very good. The vast majority of patients recover with antibiotics and return to their normal state of health. There is, however, a subgroup of patients that has ongoing symptoms even after antibiotic therapy. This condition is called post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. This post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome is a condition that's really characterized by a constellation of symptoms: fatigue, musculoskeletal pain, and cognitive complaints like difficulty with short-term memory or speed of thinking or multitasking. This constellation of symptoms is the characteristic by which we identify post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. Post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome may be especially common in people that have had neurologic involvement, and the rates of post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome after neurologic involvement may be as high as 20% or even higher. Without neurologic symptoms, the rates of post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome tend to be less, in the 10 to 20% range. The term post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome does not imply a specific causation, however. The cause of post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, in other words, why do those 10% of patients have persistent symptoms after antibiotics? That is one of the major focuses of the research at Johns Hopkins, is trying to understand what actually causes those underlying symptoms to persist after antibiotic therapy. There's many different hypotheses and an extensive debate about the possible causes. The debate ranges from whether the persistent symptoms are related to leftover bacteria that have not been completely eradicated to treatment. There's some evidence for that in animal models of Lyme disease. The Lyme disease literature suggests that post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome may be related to autoimmunity, and that the symptoms aren't from an autoimmune syndrome that's taken over the patient's condition after antibiotic treatment. The term post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome is agnostic to the cause. It doesn't imply one cause versus another. It just acknowledges that there's a very real entity of ongoing illness after treatment of Lyme disease that is very real and can be defined using specific criteria that we employ in the Lyme Center. Part of the research at the Hopkins Lyme Center is to understand the specific mechanisms of this illness so that better treatments can be designed that would specifically focus and target the mechanism of this illness. Currently, there's no FDA-approved treatment for post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, and treatment must be individualized through your primary care physician, focusing on the specific types of symptoms that you're having, and focusing on your primary care physician's knowledge and comfort level with treating this condition. The best information about prognosis actually comes from studies of people with late Lyme arthritis. This is the subgroup of patients in stage 3 Lyme disease that have joint swelling and late Lyme arthritis. Mm-hmm. 10% of patients after that extensive treatment may remain symptomatic. They may continue to have swelling of the joints and pain. And the condition has been termed antibiotic refractory late Lyme arthritis. This is in patients that don't actually recover completely after the antibiotics are completed. This 10% group is thought to have an autoimmune arthritis. Extensive research has shown that the bacteria can no longer be found in the tissue or fluid of patients that have this antibiotic refractory condition. The condition is thought to be perpetuated by our own immune system. This is called autoimmunity, where our own immune system continues to inflame the tissues, continues to cause swelling and pain, even in the absence of detectable bacteria. Patients are often referred to the Lyme Disease Research Center for evaluation of chronic Lyme disease. Chronic Lyme disease is a condition that patients often seek consultation regarding. In the Lyme Center, we look at chronic Lyme disease as a starting point for their evaluation. Chronic Lyme disease is kind of an umbrella term that probably encompasses many different subsets of illness. For example, it's very similar to a patient concern about chest pain. When somebody comes into an emergency room with chest pain, the doctor doesn't know whether the patient's suffering from anything as mild as food-related esophageal symptoms or acid reflux, or something incredibly serious like a myocardial infarction. They both present with chest pain. Similar situation occurs in chronic Lyme disease. We view this as a starting point to determine what's actually causing the symptoms. The symptoms of chronic Lyme disease are very similar and overlap with other conditions because there are symptoms such as fatigue and pain and cognitive symptoms that have many different etiologies. When we evaluate patients with the concern over chronic Lyme disease, we dig down deep and do an extensive evaluation, and we find that patients end up having many different final diagnoses. Sometimes the final diagnosis is not at all related to Lyme disease. They may have an endocrine condition such as thyroid disease. They may have an autoimmune condition such as rheumatoid arthritis. They may have a condition related to a different infection, not Lyme disease. Our extensive evaluation shows that patients usually fall into several major categories. One of those categories is post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. And so we do everything we can to try to define the patient's exposure to Lyme disease and their history that would substantiate the diagnosis of post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. Not everyone after extensive evaluation will have a final diagnosis, unfortunately, because of the symptoms of chronic Lyme disease. Fatigue and pain are nonspecific. In the case of post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, we do have a final etiologic diagnosis. We know that the patient had Lyme disease, they were treated, and that their symptoms persisted after antibiotic treatment.